Good morning, everybody. Myself, I am Gandhi Bari. I am working in Assistant Professor of Computer Science Department in the GVN College, Kovilpatti. Now we discuss the data communication in the second chapter. So how to communicate in the data for future use in the network. So here we discuss about network models. Previous session, we have discussed the basic what are the things we have used in the networks. Here we used in the model of network. So basic, we will use the network in the OSI model. OSI means Open System Interconnection. It will be developed by the International Organizations for Standardization, ISO, Model for Understanding and Developing Computer-to-Computer Communication Architecture that is flexible, robustness and interoperable. So it will be the basic model we have used in the all networks. It is not a protocol. It is the architecture to how the network can be worked inside. It developed in 1980s, divides the network architecture into 7 layers. OSI, each layer, 7 layers, for each layer performs a subset of the required communication function. Each layer relies on the next lower layer to perform more primitive functions. So that is the each layer has some functions. It will be completing to the next layer. Each layer provides services to the next higher layer. Changes in one layer should not require changes in the another layer. Layer 1, 2, 3 are the network support layer. It will be deals with the physical aspects of moving data from one device to another device. Layer 5, 6, 7 are the user support layer, allow the interoperability among unrelated software. Layer 4 ensures that what the layer have transmitted is in the form that upper layer can be used. OSI layers are, first layer is, that is topmost layer is the application layer, next layer is the presentation layer, session layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, physical layer. Physical layer, data link layer, network layer are the three lower level layers. Application layer, presentation layer, session layers are the higher level layers. Transport layer is the mid-level layer. It will be transporting the communication to the upper and lower. So OSI layer architecture, here one device A and B will be connected in the network. So device A can 7 layers in the architecture model. Device B can have the 7 layers. So how it will be worked in that architecture? So device A, suppose we have to use one example. So device A is the sender, device B is the receiver. Device A can be send one message to device B. So application layer, first you have to open whatever message we have to type, or you can use the mail, or you can use the MS Word, or you can use the notepad, or it may be any application software we have used. So it will be composed into presentation layer passed into the session layer. The session layer breaks the content into the transport layer. Transport layer, it will be transporting to the which network we have used to transport the content of the message to the receiver. So receiver is the one network. So it will be find out and capturing the network address to here to send the original message. Network layer, it will be passing the or designation address. Data link layer, it will be converted the original packet into split into the frames. So the frames are sent into the physical layer. Physical layer, it will be the physical communication between the sender A and the sender B. Okay, physical communication, it will be passing the message into the receiver. So receiver, it will be receiving the message to the physical cable, and the data, it will be passed into the data link layer. Data link layer, it will be passed into the network layer. So here somewhat functions are have, and in the next slide we have to discuss the detailed explanation of each and every layer. So transport layer, transporting the message into the upper layer, session, presentation and application layer. So application, we have received the original content of the message. Receiver can open the content and view the messages. So next is protocol data units. At each layer, protocols are used to communicate. Control information is added to the user data and each layer. For example, the transport layer may fragment user data. Each fragment has a transport header and added designation address, sequence number, error detection code. This will be creates a transport protocol data unit. It will be used in each and every layer. So, an exchange using the OSI model. So, first layer, seventh layer is the application layer. It will be contain the original data D7 and the header function. And the next layer is the presentation layer. The original data is D6 and H6 up to the session layer, transport layer, network layer. D2 is one is the unique difference between other layers in the data link layer. Data link layer have the two pointers. One is T2 and H2. T2 is the header pointer and H2 is the tailor pointer. So next last lower level is the physical layer. Physical layer, it will be converted into the bit streams. Bit streams, the original data can be converted into bit streams. The bit streams are transmitted in the transmission medium through, it will be the cable. Cable passing the information to the receiver side. Receiver, it will be open the bit streams into data link layer. Data link layer, it will be receiving the data from the tailor and header. So up and so on, all the layers are passing the message into the receiver. So next layers 1, 2, 3. So physical layer, data link layer, network layer are the layer 1, 2, 3. It's the layer 3 device component. Here is the lower level layer. Layer 2 and 3 addressing schemes we needed to use in the network. Layer 1 is the addressing scheme is not needed. It will be the physical cable. First layer is the physical layer. Physical layer is the main responsibilities of transmitting individual bits from one to next. Physical characteristics of interface and media. Representation of bits, a stream of bits, zeros and ones. Next one is the data rate and synchronization of bits. Line configuration. What is the physical topology we have used in the physical layer? Transmission mode. The physical topology and transmission mode is the main important thing we have used in the physical layer. So remaining also the data characters. Physical layer, that is the image we have to display. From the sender, we can receive the data link layer to be converted into the bit streams. Converting the message bit streams into the physical cable medium to the receiver side physical layer. Receiver side physical layer receives the bit streams and pass it to the data link layer. So here the transmission medium, the how it will be transmitted in the signals. It will be the digital signals to be passed. Layer 2 is the data link layer. It's the main responsibilities of moving frames from one hop to next hop. That is next hop means next layer. So moving frames means physical layer, it will be data in the form of bit streams. Data link layer, data in the form of frames. So frames means dividing the bit streams into a groups. The certain groups is called as a frames. So framing, dividing the stream of bits received from the network layer, manageable data units called frames. So next important thing is the data link layer is physical address. So the physical address is the MAC address. MAC address means media access control. What the network media we have used in the receiver side. So the network address will be passed into the physical address. So original system IP address. So next is the flow control. Flow control mechanism we have to discussed in the previous video session. Flow control, data flow control. Simplex method, half duplex method, full duplex method. What mechanism we have used in the application OSI model. So depends upon your application, we have used in the flow controls. Next one important concept is error control. Error control is the main responsibilities, that is main function in the data link layer. If you have to receive the bit streams, it will be errored. Added a trailer to the end of each frames. The trailer will be indicate what the message we have received, what the message we will miss in the transmission physical media. So it will be easily identified by the error control mechanism we have used in the data link layer. So each frames we have added a header and a trailer. So header is the source address and designation address. So Taylor, it will be continuity of the next message. It becomes whole bit streams will be divided into frames. So we have used in the error control mechanism. So next is the access control. Access control means what type of network we have used to control the or it will be passed into the data. Next one is the hop-to-hop delivery. Which system we have used, that is device may be used in the one sender is another device where configurations are different and receiver is the device and configurations are the different. So it will be matching to the data network. So next one is the data link layer. So data link layer, here is the examples what will be done in the data network layer, that is link layer. Receive the, that is sender side, we have sent the message from the network layer, it will be passed into the data link layer. So data link layer, the original data can be added in the Taylor and the header. So the header and Taylor will be added and the physical media transmitted. Here is the bit streams are grouped into frames. So here three frames are under below. We have three frames are in the original data message. So the three frames are sent to the physical media through the next receiver side. So receiver side data link layer, we have removed the Taylor and will be composed into the original message. The header is the what is the source address, what the designation address, what will be the how much of data we can be sent. It will be included in the header. So hop to hop delivery. So how does the network can be used in the delivery mechanism we have used. So end system A. So another one end system is D. Here A, B, C and E, F, these are also the hop to hop delivery. That is how the layers can be worked in the delivery mechanism. So system A, we have using the A, hop to hop delivery. We have using the two layers, physical layer and data link layer. So the data can be sent the A machine to the B. So B here is the router. So the cross symbol indicate in the network picture, it will be the router. Router means route the direction we have used to send the system or receive the system. Now what will be locate the system where have to place in the network. So here we have to send the message from A to D. It will be using the B, C network layers. That is routers can be used. The router route the direction to the system D. So and we have to pass A to F means we have to find out the routers A, B, E and F. So B we have using two layers, physical layer and data link layer. One is the source address, next one is the designation address. So another we have using the another network configuration layer, that is router. Router E. E is we have using two layers, physical layer and data link layer. So one is the source and another one is the designation. So another designation we have reaching the end of the system. So the end of the system does not need any address of the designation. So it will be the original system, final system. So it will be receiving the message. This is the examples for hop to hop delivery. How it will be the network can be transmitted the data from one source machine to another designation machine. So next layer is the network layer. The network layer is main responsible for delivering individual packets from the original source to the final destination node. Okay, here is the data, it will be in the form of packets. Physical layer, it will be data in the form of bit streams. Data link layer, data in the form of frames. Network layer, data in the form of packets. You have to think, friends, how the chocolate is made. What are the ingredients? That is, what are the chocolate we have used in the, some of the ingredients we have used, choco powder and sweetness and some other things. So it will be made upon individual, it will be mixed into a chocolate in the form. It will be covered into the white color wrapper and color and brand wrapper will be covered by. So here packet, it's the one type of covering the original data. Covering the original data means it will be securing the data from source address and designation address. So next one is the logical addressing. If the packet pass the network boundary, we need another addressing system to help. Source to designation connection. So next one important function is routing. Here one of the major network layer we have using the router. Routing means route or directions the path between source to designation. route are switch the packet to the final destination. Source to destination delivery. Here, data link layer, hop to hop delivery. Network layer here, source to designation delivery. That is end to end delivery. So here the network layer, how it is will be function. Here see friends, the picture is having original data and only in the header. So not for the tailor. Data link layer only having the tailor. So another remaining layers are having the header only. Source to designation delivery in the network layer. So system N, system A and the same examples, but only one thinking we have using the another layer added in the each and every system. System A, physical layer, data link layer, network layer. So same examples, router again it will be B and E containing the network layer. So the final system F, it will be containing the original designation, that is source to designation delivery. So for the physical three layers are using to communicate. The next layer is transport layer. So transport layer is responsible for service point or port addressing. Okay, here a port addressing means the network can be in different types of network we have used it. So previous slide, that is previous session, we have using the addressing schemes. That is switched WAN, switched LAN. So there's different types of network we have used. So what are the address, what are the port we have to use the finding the address, you have used the connections passing the data. So segmentation and reassembling. A message is divided into transmittable segments, each segment containing a sequence number. So it will here in the data in the form of segment. Previous layer, network layer, data in the form of packets. Here will be data in the form of segment. So the segment containing the sequence number. The sequence number is used to identify the data, that is continuity of the data. Next important responsibilities is connection control, connection oriented or connectionless services we have used in this network. Connection oriented means we have using the protocols will be different from the connectionless. Connection oriented means we have using the TCP/IP protocols we have used. Connectionless means wireless connections. So wireless connections we have using the so much of protocols we have used in the network. So next one is the important concept, flow control and error control. It will be sending how the data can be flowed and how much of data can be errored. So it will be used to rectify the flow control and error control. So here the transport layer examples, the original data from the session layer to transport layer in the sender side. The sender side receives the original data into segments, each segments having the data and the header. So the header included in the sequence number. The sequence number is used to identify the continuity of the data. So here it will be passed into the transport layer. So receiver side transport layer, it will be removing the header, that is sequence number, and it will be composed into original data to pass into the session layer. So next, reliable process. Here transport layer, how it will be passed the information means reliable process. That is process to process delivery of message. Okay, yes, and so it will be sending the message into the receiver. So through the internet, network layer, host to host delivery we can use. Transport layer, process to process delivery we can use. So next layer is session layer. Session layer, the main responsibilities of dialog control and synchronization. So dialog control means designs to establish the network and maintaining the network and synchronize the network, that is interaction between the communicating system, that is source to end systems. So next important responsibilities is synchronization. It will be allow the process to add checkpoints or synchronization points to your data streams. It will be continuity of the data, where have to pass the data, where have to break the data. So it will be the synchronizations. Session layer, here synchronization point will be added in the each data frames. Okay, so the sender side session layer is each data will be splitted into session and header. So synchronization point will be added into the each sessions. Synchronization points joining the data will be or connecting the data to transmit the receiver side Receiver side. Receiver side receiving the data using the synchronization point. So it will be continuity, that is joining of data. That is, it will be used for joining of data where have to receive. So it will be compose the original data to the presentation layer. So next important layer is presentation layer. Design the handle the syntax and semantic of the information exchanged between two systems. So what are the syntax and semantics? Syntax means what are the basic method we have used to transport the message. Semantic means what is the rules we have used in the information exchange. So the syntax and semantics is very important. It will be in the presentation layer. Add a design for data translation, encryption, decryption and compressions. These are also the techniques, data translation, encryption, decryption and compression, all the techniques. It will be mainly used for data security. So we have used in the presentation layer. So presentation layer, the original data, it will be heading, it will be original header will be added in the presentation layer. It will be receiving side, the header will be removed. The original data, it will be passed into the next level, that is application layer. So next layer, the last layer is the application layer. The application layer is responsible for providing service to the user. So providing services means what are the services, what are the main softwares we have used to receive the messages, or we have to receive the content of the data. We have using so much of services. We have used the mail services, file access, file transfer mechanism, file management mechanism we have used. Remote login or network virtual terminals we have used in the application layer. Accessing the World Wide Web. We have so much of data we have searching in the network. So we have using the World Wide Web. So next one is the directory service. These are also the applications we have used in the end users. So application layer, here is the original data and the header messages will be added. So receiver side, the header messages will be removed from the data. The original data in the form of mail or telnet or HTTP. What are the applications we have used to compose the message? So the same application will be used to extract the data from the receiver side. Okay, the summary. So what are the layers we have discussed? The seven layers are physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, application layer. Here the side, some important functions to be noted in that each and every layers. Physical layer, to transmit bits over a medium to provide the mechanical and electrical specification. Data link layer, to organize the bits into frames to provide a hop-to-hop delivery. So network layer, to move packets from source to designation to provide internetworking. Transport layer, to provide reliable process to process message delivery to error delivery. So next one is the session layer. Session layer, to establish and manage and terminate the sessions. Presentation layer, to translate, encrypt and compress the data. Application layer, to allow access to network resources. These are also the basic functions we have used in the OSI layered architecture. Here application, presentation, session. The upper layers are we have using the data in the format of streams. Transport layer, we have the data in the format of segments. Network layer, we have using the network header will be added and the original data in the format of packets. Here see the examples, the data shielded in the segment, another network layer, network header and data, it will be shielded in the packets. Net data link layer, it will be converted into frames. So frames we have using the header and tailor, it will be shielded from the frames, that is it whole terms will be called as a frames. Physical layer, we have using the bit streams, zeros and the original data in the form of zeros and ones. TCP IP protocols route. The TCP IP protocols route is a hierarchical architecture, that is hierarchical protocol made of five layers. Physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, application layer. So that these five layers are we have using the TCP IP protocol. TCP means transmission control protocol. IP means internet protocol. It will be mainly used for the upper and lower layers. It will be transporting the data from the lower and upper layers. So some protocols we have used in the TCP IP suite. So here one of the IP TCP. It is the main protocols we have used in the network transmission, that is message conversations or message transmitting. So the remaining protocols we have used in the depending upon your applications, we have used in the network. Okay, so MIME means multi-purpose internet mail extension protocols. PGP means border gateway protocols. Border gateway protocols means we have crossing the two network. Crossing the two network means it will be one of the systems in the local area network, another one of the system in the WAN, wide area network. So it will be crossing the border. So we have used in the border gateway protocols. So next one, FTP is the file transfer protocol. So next one is the HTTP, hypertext transfer protocol. SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol. Telnet, SNMP. SNMP means simple network management protocols. So these are also the applications we have used in the network. So depending upon your applications, we have used in the above protocols, FTP, HTTP, SMTP. We have composing the mail and send into the another person, Abhina, we have used the SMTP, that is simple mail transfer protocol we have used. So here it is the TCP is the connection oriented network. UDP is the connectionless network. So UDP protocol mainly used for simple network management protocols. Okay. So IP have the four types of protocols we have used. ICMP. ICMP means internet control message protocols. What the network it will be passing the message. What are the basic characters we have needed to composing the message. So it will be the internet control message protocols. So next one is the internet group management protocol, OSPF. OSPF means open shortest path first. Which technique we have used to control the network. So that is open shortest path first in the network. It will be used to connect the network. So RSVP, resource reserver serveration protocols, that is reserveration, the one of the sender is in the another server, so next receiver is in the another server, now it will be connecting with the reservation protocol we have used here. So these are all the main protocols we have used in the TCP IP suite protocols. So TCP IP protocol suite, the layers within the TCP IP protocol suite do not exactly match those in the OSI model. The original TCP IP protocol suite was defined as having four layers, host to network, internet, transport and the application layers. However, when TCP IP is compared to OSI, we can say that the TCP IP protocol suite is made of five layers. The five layers are physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer and application layer. So here is the examples, what are the layers we have used in the, what are the protocols we have used in this architecture. Physical data link layer, no protocols we have used, it will be underlying the network, that is the physical communication. Network layer we have using the protocols ICMP, IGMP, it will be the IP protocols, internet protocols, RRAP, that is ARP protocols we have used. Transport layer we have using SCTP protocol, TCP protocol, UDP. But these are also the expansion for here we have used in this layer. So all the protocols we have explained in the expansion, that is abbreviations here. So next the session, presentation, application layers are original datas we have composed in. That is SMTP, FTP, HTTP, DNS, SNMP and Telnet. These are also the TCP IP protocols stored in the OSI model architecture. Thank you students. The remaining sessions will be continued in the next videos. Thank you students.